welcome to my channel. My name is Laura and today I'm going to be sharing my thrift haul for this week. I went thrifting with a friend and a couple of, like, with my husband, and then in a hurry also. So I found a few things, not so much, but some really, really cool items, including a painting that I already sold locally on Facebook Marketplace. It was beautiful, and I'll attach a picture of that painting here at the end of the video. So let me start pulling from this pile of things. There is some, like, smaller items. One of my favorites though is this really cool brass kind of pedestal mirror tray. It is vintage and I paid $2 for it, which I thought it was amazing for the size and the weight and the age of this item. So $2, that's really cool, and I'm gonna list it right away. I also found this little oil lamp for $3.99. It's so beautiful, so delicate, and I think it's like, it has a lot of curves and makes it really, really, I want to say, like, delicate and whimsical, when sometimes these lamps tend to be like more straight lines or streamlines, but this one has like the curves, so I really, really like it. And I paid $3.99 for this one. I think I had a coupon, I'm not sure. But $4, I think, is a good deal, and I will flip it for like maybe 10 to 12. So not that huge profit, but I just love rescuing these kinds of things. And I feel like this is something that you can just style somewhere in your kitchen or in a bookshelf, but I will do it in the kitchen, I think. And it will look really nice, and it is functional because it has every piece that it needs to be functioning. So I got that one. I got this one just because I love pottery, Mexican pottery, and this is just a cute accent. It could be hang in one of those hooks in the kitchen with some plants. You can put toothpicks when, you know, entertaining. You can put matches in here. So I think it's functional, but very cute as well. I also found the next thing item here that I have is this little kind of bench table that is in the form of a flower. So this is not an old item, but I like the detail. I have a painting that is kind of like this, and I should use it for my birthday theme because it's actually very similar to this. I'll show you that in a minute. So I have this one, and I think this could be cool with a plant, but also it could be cool on top of a table to give some different heights, or if you have like a cake or desserts in the table. I think this will look really nice on that one, and I'll show you the picture right away. Hold on. Here is the picture, and I had this picture for a long time. It's even the same kind of pink color. So I'm kind of excited to pair these two. This was 99 cents. My plan is to sell this one, but I always like to, like, if I can use them once, and then look at that. It works perfectly together, right? And I'm not a roses gal, but I think around my birthday, I always like pink roses. For some reason, I think it's just because it's a springy birthday. So the following items here were on sale. Oh, you know what? This I bought when it was 50% off. I had a coupon. So I also got these ones. They were $3 for the two of them, which I thought it was okay. I don't know why these things are not selling as they should. They are very beautiful, so maybe I just need to style them better. I'll try to work on my pictures for this one. The next item I have is this cool picture. This is a painting of this guy who, I hope he's wearing underwear, and he's sitting on that chair staring at something. I think he's reading a book. I think I see this like a book here, but I love the colors on this one. This is probably an acrylic, but it doesn't have the shine of oil, and it is not so big, but I paid only $150 for this one. So I'm excited to find this guy a frame that will make him look even cooler. The next item in the pile is this sign that says welcome, that is very rusted, heavy iron. And I love the shape on this one, the ornaments in here, the writing. I will put this inside of a pot or by my walkway towards the house. This was outside for sure. So, I mean, this is what these things are made of. And I love that it's, you know, a thing that will last forever, as opposed to like something from the dollar store that is plastic and that you have to update like every year or every so many years, right? So I got that one for $2. There is these two items here that work together. And they were $1 each, so $2 for the pair. And I love this kind of thing, like giant things. It's either giant things or tiny things, like miniatures, right? That is like really pretty. So I got the spoon and the fork. They are not great quality. They are cheap and light. It is metal. They were originally $10 somewhere, each one of these things. So I was glad to grab them for $1 each. I think that's more reasonable for the quality of the item. And this is something that you can just, I will put it outside or in the kitchen or where your dining table is, something like that. Ah, hold on. I found me a big planting pot. I will be planting a lot. I want to be putting some flowers out there, so we'll do that. Oh, and then this haul, I have some exciting things here. I just look at them, but I'm going to do all the other things first. So, these ones were unusual, and I got them for spring, for Easter. I did not end up using them. I put them up on my table setting, but I thought they will be very dangerous with my little kids. They will be spilling drinks. So I'm thinking this will work more as a centerpiece than as a placemat. I love the moss on this one, and it has like a branch here. Some of these is plastic, and then some of this is actual organic, you know, like actual branches and moss. So I think they're very beautiful. There was this pile of 8 of them for $11, I think, and that's what I grabbed. Let me check if there's actually 8 of them, but yeah. So there is 8 of them, and this will be really cool also to like make a fairy garden on top of it. So I was thinking like different options, like this could be cool in a centerpiece and you have your flowers or a fairy garden. Yeah, like if I was still a teacher, that would be cool to do as an activity for kids, like to build their own fairy garden and then they grab it and take it home. The few next items I have here are fun too. I was able to grab, this is noisy, sorry. This candlestick for $2.99. It's okay, not a great find, but these ones are becoming really expensive everywhere I go. So I like to grab them and I like to resell them. And then these ones, it was $6 for these 3 of them. So this is cool because they are kind of like already in a set. These ones are friends, you can tell. And I think this one as well. They are all the same kind of shape. So they are a family. For $6, I thought they were great. They have a Made in India sticker in the bottom. So I love brass. I love brass accents. And I think they're just so beautiful. I grabbed this to make my birds or my insects here in the garden drink in place. So this was half of $9.99, so $5. The color, I'm not so sure I like it, but I love these curves, this scallop kind of thing, and the ruffly design on it. The weight on this as well. And this is Ironstone USA. So it is a quality piece. It is heavy and it pains me to think of painting it. I kind of feel guilty about doing that. because it's a quality piece. So you guys let me know, should I paint it or not? And I'll show you the base. The base of this, it will be something like that, but it's a different shape. And it's a color that does not match. So I need to paint the base. And I will fill it up with concrete so that it's super sturdy and heavy, and then glue this guy on top. But like I said, I kind of feel guilty about putting this, glue it, and paint it. So you guys let me know. Maybe I should find something cheaper or something not so good quality. But I don't want something that will be unsafe to drink from. So that's my issue. I'm like, it needs to be something that it's that you can put, it's food safe, right? To put water in there. But at the same time, I don't know if I want to do vintage ironstone in there. This item, okay, so I am beginning in that journey of making my own bread. I'm trying to become more and more healthy and more involved in at home. We have a garden, we have chickens, and it's not quite a homestead yet. I mean, we try, we are learning. We come from the desert. I grew up where hardly anything grew. My grandma was great at like growing things, but things just don't grow by themselves there where I was at. And then we came here to the northern, you know, in the States, and there is all these plants and all these weeds that grow by themselves, which is a challenge, right? But it's also wonderful because we have a cherry tree, we have apricots that it's like huge, a huge tree of apricots. And then we do zucchini, tomatoes, and peppers and stuff like that. So we started having chicken, and now the next step is to have sourdough bread, right? And somebody gave me starter, and I'm loving it. And today I baked my first loaf. So I'm so excited with my sourdough bread. I'll see how it looks and how it tastes and how, you know, it works for me. But when I was in that journey, okay, I got the starter and I'm like, well, now I need a Dutch oven, right? And that next morning, I was like, I'm going to go to the thrift store and see what I find. I found 3 Dutch ovens that day, which I think is ridiculously lucky. So the first one I'm going to show you, I paid $30 for, which in Dutch oven world, it's a good price, right? So this one right here, it's a good size and it is new. It even has the plastic to prevent the lid of ruining the bottom. And it is in beautiful condition. So right here it is. So I thought, okay, I'll buy this one, right? And it has the metal handle, and I found it on Amazon. It sells for $80. So $30, I was like, this is a fantastic deal. So I grabbed it because I wanted to be safe. But then I found another one. Okay, so the second one, I was able to clean it with baking soda. And it looks great. It looks great, but the handle of the lid doesn't seem to be metal. It seems like something else. So I am not so sure I want to put it in the oven, right? So $10 for that one. I was like, I'll grab it just in case. What if it works, right? Because it's not that bad. And let's face it, after I use it once or twice, it's going to look just like that. And then I go to Savers and I find one that is a little bit more on the used dirty side, but not broken. It has metal on top. And I pay $4.99 for it. And that's what I'm using right now to bake my bread in. So I am so excited. So I'm gonna be selling this one that I paid $30 for. I'm gonna probably make, I don't know, I'm thinking like $50 so that I can pay for the other two that I got. And I have the one with the plastic handle or the non-metallic handle. I make my soup on it. And then the other one I'm using it for bread. So I'm super excited. I'll show you my new pots that I have there. And I'm excited also to be making my own bread. So that's the story. But I'm telling you, if you guys need something, just go to the thrift store first. And go to several thrift stores. And go early in the morning when they're just putting things out. Or find out when they're pulling things out. Because my Goodwill here, I'm realizing they put things out around 1:30. So I love it. Now I go there and I'm finding cool things. And I have a few things that I found because I went at that time. So I'll show you these three last items. So I found these guys in this beautiful wood. And it has a wood grain here. You can see the different colors. This is a lot more detail, ornated, and delicate, right? And I paid 99 cents for each one of these ones. And that day, it was the only thing I grabbed. So I thought it was totally worth it. This could be style, because they're kind of sculptural. So even if you don't want to put a candle in them, I think they're pretty like that. This is more like, to me, this is more mid-century looking. And then this one is more sculptural, boho looking. So yeah, just two different styles. Then I found this pocket change tray. It was $2.99. It's a classic. Most people that thrift and that thrift brass have seen this. So I was excited to bring it home. And I'm not planning on listing it for a huge amount of money, but I know that this is a classic. And then lastly, this is a newer item from World Market. So I know that it was not cheap. Actually, it says it was like $22 and I paid $6. And this is a propagation station thing where you will put your cuttings of your vines or whatever plants you have, and then you put them in water and you wait for them to get roots. And I've seen people selling that online. Like, they sell each one of those cuttings for $5, which I think is a fantastic idea, because if you are a plant mom or dad, and you're good at it, you can be making money out of your plants, because, you know, they need to be pruned. They need to be pruned often, so this is a fun thing to do. And then it's cheaper for someone like me that I want to buy plants, and I don't want to buy a $50 plant that I might kill. I'll better start with a cutting that it was only like $5 or something like that. So anyways, this is my haul for today. I'll show you the pots. I'll show you the painting. So stay tuned. This is the one that I paid $10 for. So it has this. And if you guys know, let me know. Maybe I can use this in the oven. So, and here's my soup that I made for today. It's early in the morning, but you know, I'm already done with lunch. And then I just uncover, this is the other lid. This is the like more used one. So let me pull my bread from the oven. Should be done now. So here it is, the moment of truth. This is my bread. I don't know if it's a rock. I don't know if we're gonna be able to eat it. But this is the pot that I paid $5 for. So I was stoked. And if I pull this out, let me show you the bottom. It is used. Which, I don't know if it's a bad thing. But I think it just worked great. And I already cooked beans in there. And I already cooked some other thing. So now I'm gonna cut my bread and see how it's doing. So here it is. This is not looking good. Maybe it is good. The crust is really good. Oh, it is good. Look. It's actually good, Nog. And the crust is so crunchy. You can eat this with butter. I think I did good. Hold on. Okay, my son wanted to react to my bread. Go ahead. All right, you tell me if it's gross.
No, it's actually good.
Yeah, you like it?
The butter makes it good, like better.
The crunch?
Mm-hmm.
Yep. Is it too sour?
It's not sour. Well, kind of like in the middle of it, it starts turning a little sour.
Mm-hmm. Because it's sourdough bread. That's why it's a little bit sour. So you like it? Mm-hmm. I'm glad. Yay! So here is the painting. Isn't it so beautiful? I completely love it. I think it's just so fantastic. Then I also found this brown table, and I was able to sell it right away. And then this, finally, this metal shelf with marble. I only paid like, I think I want to say $12 at Savers. So anyways, those are my finds for this week. Thank you very much for watching. I'll see you next week. And please subscribe, like, and share. Bye.